Emotions. Today we would like to speak about emotions, a full range of emotions. We would like you to look at all species upon earth, human, as well as animal, and see for yourself what emotions really are. When we look at many animal species, we see a range of emotions. Some have less, but some are very similar. What many have in common is a strong sense of protecting themselves, a strong sense of protecting territory. When you look at lions, they will protect their territory, not really out of anger or love, even though those emotions are mingled in. It is about protecting the group, their young, and less about themselves sometimes. The love emotion is more a love related to protection of their offspring, making sure their species will survive. The anger emotion is used as a power to defeat the ones that try to interfere with their instinct of survival. The animals don't define their emotions, as they act on instinct more than thought. Humans are different in a way that they can think, but even basic instincts are present within each human. Animal species are controlled in a natural way by the availability of food and ideal living circumstances, but they can adjust themselves sometimes in some way. But nature is usually the main factor of control, either through other species, or different natural circumstances. This changed when humans became more present on Earth and animals were in a way forced to share their territory with humans, humans who could be killed, but humans who are able to think and found ways to kill the animals first. This did have an effect on animals, and some would become more aggressive, we could say more anger would be expressed, or the emotion that normally would be their need to protect would change and became stronger and turned into a form of anger. Their basic instincts and range of emotions was influenced by something that was not their normal enemy. As we can understand, it did not make them love each other more, but it made them protect each other and themselves more. In a way, many animals had to become more selfish and not to be killed themselves. When normally they would defend or attack, and many time both sides would survive. Now with humans present and hunting them, they could protect, but doing this also meant a greater chance of being killed. Which also means they had to become more aggressive in protecting their own species. Of course, we know that many species lost the fight between them and humans. Humans like to take emotions to the extreme, finding ways to even explain emotions that they are feeling. Humans include words like love, passion, anger, and hate, fear, and more. Animals will follow their basic instincts and only feel stronger emotions without defining them. Animals would never consider anger a bad emotion, as the feeling alone is what keeps them protected, keeps them alive, keeps their species alive. Humans work differently, as they consider love an emotion that keeps them alive. In reality, it is the anger emotion that keeps humans alive, by having humans protect their territory, their species, their beliefs, and more. Now we call it an anger emotion as most see it this way. In reality, the basis is an instinct that makes us act just like animals. It doesn't mean we are the same as animals, but humans like to use anger and love to make distinctions between themselves and animals by making the distinction that because humans can think, they are not the same. This is true. Humans have taken emotions and have explored them more extremely because humans can think and find or can explain emotions. Humans have suppressed in a way that survival instinct, as more humans are upon earth and the fight for territory like they had in the past has become a fight for territory inside a home, and sometimes those homes are so close to each other that even that fight is becoming more impossible. This is resulting in the emotion of protecting and fighting for territory, turning into an emotion that is more strongly felt as anger. The basic for the emotion of anger is self-protection. But humans are in many ways even more controlled, or live more controlled lives than animals. Anger is a very powerful emotion and can felt even more strongly than all other emotions, and it brings fear to the ones that feel the anger emotion energy toward them. It is a feeling of fear that kicks in as a basic instinct of protection, protecting themselves. But humans have been going through deeper and deeper control systems that in most ways has taken away or suppressed their basic instincts and in this way consider many emotions wrong. This includes anger and fear. Protecting their own is even something that in some way is about to be considered wrong as humans are going even deeper into control of their emotions or basic instincts. Humans have a tendency to go extreme at times instead of following their basic instincts as humans. The greatest reason for this is the control that has been imposed. Partly due to so many humans upon Earth, partly a greater need to control such a great amount of humans upon Earth. We can look at the animals. They would never allow what humans are doing. Just imagine a group of gorillas sharing their territory in a way humans do by even stacking house upon house. Just think, a group of gorillas on the ground, a group in the middle part of the trees and another group in the top of the trees. Humans have adjusted to this, but not without consequences. Their emotions have grown more extreme, and by this we mean all emotions, love, hate, anger, fear and more. If we take a look at small tribes, they will fight over territory, not to the death most of the time, but just to defend having enough food to eat for their family. Having enough natural resources in their territory to survive. They do not look at this as we have to love everyone, we cannot be angry. They look at the basics and their love and hate as well as fear are not as extreme as many of the humans that live in big cities. Their love is just that, they do not define it, as well as they do not really define their anger or fear as much as we do. They also do not use judgment of others to see if others are more loving, or more angry or more hateful. Emotions are just that, their emotions, not controlled by outside judgments and control systems. Controlling emotions has become a mainstream idea, almost a religion, and it has resulted in so many more humans on medication, under stress and it has a great effect on the human body, as the control of emotions. No matter what they are brings a great deal of stress to each human physically and mentally. The idea that controlling the emotions, transforming emotions to just feel one certain emotion defies the basic instinct and emotional part of the human that is present no matter how spiritual the human becomes. We have to stop defining and start allowing ourselves to feel our full range of emotions. In this way we do not have to control and in this way we will also not go through the suppression which usually leads to much more than just outbreaks of anger or even hate, as well as it relieves us of feeling the need to judge others. And it is better for the human body to have its energy fully flowing instead of suppressing some of the energy that normally flows through our human body as well. You cannot become a spiritual being living upon Earth by suppressing the human. You can only become a spiritual being by including the human. Petra Margolis. May 3, 2016. www.ascendmasters.org. Copyright 2016 Petra Margolis, all rights reserved. This message may be posted including the author's name and link.